Now, what we have here in chapter 3, first of all, we have Paul changed his bookkeeping system here of the past. And we are going to see how he did that. And then we're going to see in verses 10 through 19, Paul changed his purpose for the present. And then Paul changed his hope for the future. And that's important to see. Now, Paul believed that God was going to establish a kingdom on this earth. He never changed from that. But he did see that there was a marvelous, wonderful hope for believers today in Christ, both Jew and Gentile, in the body of believers, that there was coming a day when he would take his own out of the world. This is a very wonderful chapter we're going to look at. Now, when we come here to verse 1, in this section where Paul changed his bookkeeping system of the past, he says, "Finally, my brethren, rejoice in the Lord." Now, apparently, he was coming to the end of his epistle to the Philippians. You can see it was really going to be a very brief one, and it was a thank you note. And he was now drawing it to an end. And he says, "Finally, my brethren." But the Spirit of God now is going to move him on because he's only halfway through the epistle. He's only halfway through. And by the way, when your preacher says, "Now in the last place are finally my brethren," and actually he's only halfway through his sermon, don't find fault, he's just really being scriptural, because that's the way Paul did it. "Finally, my brethren," he says, "rejoice in the Lord." My wife reminded me in a conference some time ago where I was speaking, and she said, "You said, now let me say this to you here in the final case, the final analysis, and then I'll be through." And she said, "You weren't through for 15 minutes. You weren't through at all." Well, now, my wife can talk to me like that, I guess. At least she does. And I told her I was just being scriptural. Paul said, "Finally, my brethren, rejoice in the Lord." Now, you notice that's going to be his final word. "Finally, my brethren, rejoice in the Lord." That's his last word to the Philippians. "Rejoice in the Lord." I believe that if Paul was here at this microphone, I think that he would like to just say this word to you, Christian friend, wherever you are. "Finally, my brethren, rejoice in the Lord." That's his message. That's a command, by the way. And we're going to see that in the next chapter when we look at the power for Christian living. "Finally, my brethren, rejoice in the Lord." Now, to write the same things to you, to me, indeed, is not grievous, but for you it's safe. In other words, Paul says that it's been no burden to him to write this letter. There was no burden on his heart like there was when he wrote to the Galatians and wrote to the Corinthians, because there were problems in those churches. And Paul says, "Well, this has been a great joy to me. And it's perfectly safe for me to write these things to you." Now he's thought of something else.